In our previous lecture, we have started lesson number 9, that is energy resources. In that, we have covered substances-based energy resources. Okay, children, we studied different substance-based energy resources such as wood, coal, mineral oil, natural gas, atomic energy, and biogas energy, which is obtained from waste material. So all these topics have been covered in our previous lecture. Today we are going to learn about process-based energy resources. Okay, just a second. Yeah, so first one we are going to learn about is hydropower. Okay, children, the energy which is generated from water. Okay, so first one here is hydropower. Okay, and here, children, we have to keep in mind one more thing that we have learned in our lower classes about kinetic energy. So what is kinetic energy, children? Kinetic energy is the energy which is possessed by a moving object. Okay, moving object possesses kinetic energy. Okay, even in last lecture also I have given you example of moving object, right? We discuss about fan. Okay, so when fan starts rotating, it is possessing kinetic energy in it. Okay, so always remember, moving object possesses kinetic energy. So what is this hydropower, children? Hydropower is the power which is obtained from the kinetic energy of running water. Okay, so when the water is running, here you can see, okay, that the water is falling, okay, from the dam and all. So here you can clearly see that this running water is possessing what? Kinetic energy. Okay, children. So here, because of this, here power is generated. Okay, hydropower does not cause any degradation of the environment. Okay, it is environment friendly, children. There is no pollution occurring because of this energy. Okay, so see, children, hydropower, it does not cause any degradation of environment. Here, children, the water which is used in generating power, it can be again used. Okay, so here we can recycle this. Okay, children, now here I would like to give you example of Bhakra Nangal, which is in the Punjab, okay, and Koyna, which is in Maharashtra. So these are the examples of hydropower. Okay, here using this energy, children, here we are generating power. Okay, yes, moving ahead, we will study about wind energy. Next is what, children? Wind energy. Here we have been using this resource, right, children? Here we have been using this resource since hundreds of years. Okay, now for example, so people used to use this energy while sailing in the boats, right? So wind energy is used by man for various uses. But nowadays what we are doing, children, this energy is also being utilized for power generation. Okay, we are using this energy to generate power also. Okay, now for the generation of this power, okay, to generate power, we have, okay, the wind speed should be between the range 40 to 50 kilometer per hour. Okay, so it should be between this range, that is, this the wind of the speed should be between 40 to 50 kilometer per hour. Okay, so only then the power will be generated. Now here, due to this speed, children, what happens? The blades, here you can see these are the windmills, children. So when the wind starts flowing in this speed, what happens? The blades of the windmills, they turn, okay? They start rotating, okay? And again, children, moving object possesses kinetic energy. So as these blades starts rotating, they are possessing what? Kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is generated over here. Okay, and this kinetic energy is further converted into electricity. Okay, so here we are generating basically what? Electricity is generated. This electricity, now children, it can be used for various purposes such as agriculture, right? In agriculture it can be used, also for domestic use, right? We are using we are using electricity in our houses, right? We are dependent electricity for various purposes, okay, to carry out our day-to-day activities. We are dependent on it, okay. So this electricity, which is generated due to wind and all, can be used for agriculture, domestic use, and as well as in industries and factories also, okay, children. Now here, children, in this image, these are the windmill, okay, these are the windmill, okay, children. And here, when the wind is moving with the speed of 40 to 50 kilometer per hour, okay, these blades, you can see here in this on your screens, these are the blades, children, these are the blades, they start rotating, okay, they start rotating, and it, because of their rotation, because of their movement, kinetic energy is formed, it is generated, okay. Yeah, now here, children, in the states of Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, windmills have been erected at many places. So you can see windmills on various parts of India. Okay, in different states, you can see. Now, moving ahead, we will be studying about solar energy. Okay, children, the energy which is generated, we are getting this energy from the sun. Okay, so now, we know very well that we get light and heat from the sun. Yes, it is our natural source of heat and light. Okay, so the intensity of solar energy is maximum in the torrid zone, children. See, we have studied about the thermal zones, children, how the thermal zones, temperature zones have been formed. Okay, so now here, why the intensity of solar energy is maximum in the torrid zone? Because the torrid zone is receiving perpendicular sun rays, okay, the equatorial region. Okay, now children, just recall lesson number 5, 4 and 5, we have studied in that chapters, we have studied it, okay. So there we have seen that the sun rays are falling in perpendicular direction in the equatorial region, that is the torrid zone. Okay, in that region they are falling. That is why the intensity is maximum in this region, in this torrid zone. Okay, so our country, that is India, it is in the torrid zone. It lies in the torrid zone. That is why we have a lot of scope for using this energy. Okay, this energy is available for us in plenty. Okay, so that is why we can utilize this energy for various purposes. Now, children, here in this picture, you can see it is a solar cooker. Okay, it is a solar cooker, children. Okay, now see here, there are also, children, there is a solar plant, okay, which is at Sakri in Dhule, okay, Dhule district, which is in Maharashtra. So such solar plants have also been constructed, okay, in order to generate and utilize the energy, okay, solar energy. Now, children, devices such as cookers, that is solar cookers, solar lamps, heaters, vehicles, they are actually running, okay, they are running on the solar power. Okay, again I'll tell you, the energy which is obtained from the sun, okay, the generation of solar power, it actually depends on the intensity. Again I will tell you, it will always and always depend on the intensity of sun rays, okay, and also the duration of the sunshine. Okay, so this energy will be always, the generation of solar power, it will last on the duration of the sunshine, okay, clear, children, and also on the intensity of sun rays. Okay, so as our country is lying in torrid zone, that is why we have lots and lots of scope, okay, for using this energy. Nowadays, children, you can even see on various flat schemes and on the people, and also on various houses, people are actually, they have actually planted solar panels in order to generate the solar power, okay, and also they are using that energy to to warm the water and all. Okay, so for that purpose such solar panels have been used. Okay children, yeah, so we get warm water and all throughout the day. So such things have been done. Okay, now moving ahead, we will be studying about the tidal energy. Okay children, here you can see about the tidal energy. In picture you can see. Now see children, here sea waves and tides are what children? They are the movements of ocean water that go on continuously. Okay, sea waves, the waves which are generated in the seas, children, you have seen the movement of water. Sometimes when you have seen the when the water moves ahead and it comes behind, they are what? They are the waves. Okay, they are what? They are moving ahead and behind. Okay, they come back. So this movement, to and fro movement of water, okay, it is called as what? They are the waves, children. And the tidal movements of the ocean water, it actually occurs continuously, right? It is occurring continuously, children. Okay, so now here what happens? As I have told you, the moving object possesses what? It possesses kinetic energy. So here what is happening, children? The water is moving continuously. Means what is happening? It is actually possessing what? Kinetic energy. Okay, so when the moving water is actually, when the running water is possessing kinetic energy, here the energy, the tidal energy is generated. Okay, this energy is formed. Now see children, a technology has now been developed to generate power with the help of the speed and the force of the waves. Okay, you must have seen, okay, in 7th and 8th standard you are going to learn more about tides. Okay, in 7th standard there is a lesson number 3, that is tides. In that you will be studying more about, and in detail you will study about the tides, children. Okay, you must have seen near the seashore and all, okay, when you visit beaches and all, so there you must have seen that there is a certain time, okay, is being given, that during this period you are not supposed to go near the seashore and all, okay, because of the high tide or because of the low tide, and also we have to see all this. Okay, so you must have seen and you must have follow all these patterns. Okay, so here what happens, children? As because of the due to the speed and force of the waves, here what is happening, the power is being generated. So such technology has been developed. Now here what is happening, children? Electricity is what, children? Electricity is obtained from the kinetic energy. Okay children, what is happening? Electricity is obtained from the kinetic energy, right? While again I'll tell you how electricity, children, because here this moving water is possessing what? Kinetic energy. So because of this kinetic energy we can generate electricity, okay, with the help of that. Now here, children, you can see here these devices have been kept. Okay, such technology has been developed, okay, in various countries. Now what is happening, children? This energy which is generated, the power which is generated, it is what? It is pollution free and it is everlasting. Okay children, it is pollution free and it is everlasting. It does not harm our ecosystem, it is not harming our environment. It is what? It is pollution free. It can be used on a large scale. Okay children, it can be used on what? On a large scale and in our country, right? Because here our country is what? It is peninsular country, right children? So here such energy can be used for a large scale. Okay, we can obtain it, we can generate such energy on a large scale. Efforts are also here, children, have been, people, our country is initiating, okay, they are taking efforts on to start such projects in India. Okay, so you can see in these pictures, children. So here basically we are actually obtaining these energy from the sea waves and the tides. Okay, now moving ahead, we will be studying about the last one, that is geothermal energy. Okay, children, now here, children, we know about, we have studied about various movements of the earth, right? We have studied about various movements of the earth. That is, we know very well, earthquakes occurs, volcanic eruptions are happening. Okay, so there are various movements which are happening in the interior of the earth. Okay, now hot water springs have always been an object of curiosity for us children, right? We are very much curious about the hot water springs. Okay, now it is actually seen at the Vajreshwari Manikarnika places. Okay, over there it is being seen. Now, children, here what is happening in the interior of the earth, okay? The temperature, it increases by 1 degree Celsius as we move, okay? As we move in the interior of the earth at a depth of every 32 meters, what happens, children? The temperature increases by 1 degree, okay? So, when we move to the interior of the earth, what happens? The temperature, it starts increasing by 1 degrees, okay, at every 32. So after every 32 meters, we are going to see the change. We are going to see the temperature is increasing. Now what happens, children? Here, humans have actually developed a process, okay, whereby what is happening? This underground heat. Now see, children, in the interior of the earth, here what is happening? The temperature is what? The temperature is maximum, heat is there, okay? So what happens, children? Man has actually developed a process into which what is happening? Underground heat can be utilized. The heat which is present in the interior of the earth, that can be utilized to generate power. Okay, it can be utilized to generate power. We can use that heat energy. Okay, now one such project is also located at Manikaran, which is in Himachal Pradesh in India. Now see, children, here you can see in this picture, it is a geothermal power generation center, which is actually using the energy which is obtained from the interior of the earth, that is heat energy. Okay, now here, children, all the above energy resources which we have studied right now, they are what? They are abiotic, okay, which are not related to living things. Okay, in case of substance based energy resources, they were all biotic, means which were related to or which are resulting from the living organisms. Okay, children, so here these process based energy resources are abiotic, and energy resources, they cause minimum pollution. Okay, they are what, children? They are causing minimum pollution. So they are what? They are actually, they are not harming or they are not degrading our environment. They are also known as what, children? They are also known as inexhaustible energy resources. Means they are what? They are available for us in plenty. Okay, these resources are what? These resources are renewable. Okay, which can be used again and again. Now see, children, beside using all these energy resources and all, what is our main duty? Our main duty is that, children, we should use these energy resources, okay, very carefully, okay? Because why? Because the substance-based energy resources are what? They are limited, okay? They are not available for us in plenty. So it is in our hand that how we should use them, okay? Basically, what we should do, children, we should actually use when it is necessary, or we should actually use them alternatively, or non-conventional energy, okay? Non-conventional energy resources should be used to meet our needs, children, okay? So, now see, children, the demand for energy is increasing all the time. Right? Why? Because of the growing population. So as the population increases, our needs will increase. So to fulfill our needs, we will be dependent on the natural resources as well as these energy resources which are available for us. Right, children? So due to the growing population, also due to the urbanization, and due to man's growing needs, okay? So the demand of these energies have been increasing on a daily basis. So it is necessary to use them. Like I told you, we should use them alternatively, and non-conventional energy resources should be used to meet our needs, to fulfill our needs, okay? Also, children, it is necessary to use energy frugally, okay? We must always avoid unnecessary use of electricity. Okay, children, see, using electricity when it is not required, okay, we are actually, what? We are simply wasting that energy resource, okay? Yes, which should be preserved, okay? We should not use it unnecessarily, okay? So, and it is in our hand, okay, as much as possible we should conserve these energy resources so that our future generations will be able to use them, okay? So it is in our hand, okay, children? So here our lesson number 9, energy resources, is completed, okay?